Hi, it's Dr. Folakemi here again. Thank you so much, guys, for subscribing. Thank you for all the comments, the likes, the shares. I see you and I really appreciate your patronage, your followership, your questions. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Today I'm going to be talking about a common skin disorder that is usually wrongly named. So a lot of what people say, you know, when people say they have eczema, is actually not what eczema is. And for the most part, we all see people, there's one funny saying that I heard Wari Pikin say, "We day your back like eczema." I found that so hilarious. But yeah, you know that rash that people tend to have, usually on the back, on the chest. Sometimes you may have some patches on the face that's usually lighter than the normal skin. That's what people refer to as eczema. But I would like to tell you that that is a wrong terminology. Dermatologists do not refer to that as eczema. It is actually something with a much longer name, and maybe that's why the shorter name of eczema actually stuck. It is called T. vesicolor or P. vesicolor, pityriasis vesicolor or tinea vesicolor. Yes, I'm sure some people try to pronounce that and just bit their tongue. So I think that's one reason probably why, you know, it eventually was just called eczema, because most people could not pronounce the name. But it's confusing because there is actually a skin condition called eczema, which I will talk about in another video. But today I'm going to be talking about pityriasis vesicolor or tinea vesicolor, as it's called sometimes. And what it is actually a skin rash that is caused by fungal overgrowth on the skin. So it's actually a superficial fungal skin infection, which is a skin infection that affects just the surface of the skin. And what happens is we do have some fungus that live on the skin normally. So like I've said in earlier videos, our skin is not sterile. There are so many fungi, bacteria, and even some viruses and some mites that live on the skin on a day-to-day basis. So what happens is sometimes some of those organisms do pass themselves or grow beyond or past their boundary. And when that happens, they become bad. So they morph from a normal resident on the skin to being a bad person. So it's just like in the environment, you have some people who live in that environment, but sometimes they can become mischievous and become area boys or hoodlums and cause problems. That's what actually what happens when a person develops tinea or pityriasis vesicolor. The normal fungi on the skin, one of which is called the Malassezia fungus. Malassezia has about 8 or 9 different types of fungus, but this Malassezia fungus lives on the skin and is found on the skin of about 95 to 97% of human beings. However, some people do not tolerate, you know, this Malassezia fungus on the skin. And when it overgrows, it causes a reaction on the skin that results in the rash that we see, that is usually, you know, light patches, you know, scattered on the face, on the chest, on the back. Now, this Malassezia fungus likes to eat the oil or the sebum that our skin produces. So you find it on the parts of the skin that tend to have more oil than other parts. The oily parts of the skin, or the parts of the skin that have more what we call the sebaceous glands, that are the glands on our skin that produce oil. You find that on the face, on the chest, on the back, and on the scalp, there are more sebaceous glands than, say, on the arms, on the legs. So you find this particular rash mainly on the areas where you have more oil. Although in some people, it can spread to even the arms and some parts of the thighs, but it's more common on the back or on the chest. Hence that funny saying, "We day your back like eczema." I can't get over it. It's just so funny. So that's why you have more cases of tinea versicolor or pityriasis versicolor occurring in these areas. Now, some of the things that predispose people to having this fungal overgrowth include skincare practices. So like I've spoken about in previous videos, you find that people who use medicated soaps quite frequently have a higher rate of having this infection on their skin. And this is because the medicated soap wipe off the good bacteria that are meant to help control the environment and prevent some of the fungus from overgrowing. When this fungus overgrow, then they cause problems because the bacteria that are meant to be there to keep them in check are actually not there. So that's one thing that can cause or can predispose people to having P. versicolor. Another thing is oily skin. Like I've said, this fungus likes the sebum or the oil that we produce on our skin. So people who have more sebum may have an increased risk of having P. versicolor. Another thing is a genetic tendency. Some people, like I've said, just don't tolerate this fungus. So when it comes on their skin, I mean, when it grows beyond a particular level, it causes this rash. Another predisposition is immune dysfunction. If the immune system is not functioning normally or is not functioning optimally, it can increase the risk of fungal overgrowth. Because usually when the fungus begins to grow, the immune system can put it in check and make sure it doesn't pass its boundary. But if the immune system is a bit weak or slow, it can allow the fungus to grow beyond the level or proliferate beyond the level that is acceptable. And some of the things that cause reduced immunity are things like diabetes, HIV, long-term chronic diseases, things like cancer and chemotherapy. You find that people who have a chronic illness or disease also have an increased risk of developing this kind of rash. But we see it in everyday people who are perfectly healthy. Because you have it does not mean that you have a chronic illness. What I'm trying to say is that these are some of the things that can predispose people to having it. But you can be perfectly healthy and still have this rash because you have a tendency to eat genetically, because your skincare regimen is not good. And also it could be, like I said, because of health reasons. Then also a lot of people who use a lot of lightening and bleaching creams, yes, bleaching creams again, have an increased risk of developing this pityriasis versicolor. This eczema, in quotes, is actually P. versicolor or T. versicolor and not eczema. How is this treated? Good skincare practices, using a pH balanced cleanser. I will keep saying pH balance cleanser, pH balance cleanser, pH balance. Sorry, I thought I was breaking. That's one. Number two is you may need to see a dermatologist or a GP who knows about the skin. Sometimes even a community pharmacist. And what they do is recommend some topical antifungal agents for you to use on your skin. Please do not use triple action creams to treat this condition because it will go and it will come back worse than it was when you first noticed it. If you have a stubborn case of P. versicolor that does not go away with antifungal washes, then please make sure you see a dermatologist for further review and further checks. Another thing I wanted to say about P. versicolor is that it can be very stubborn, particularly in people who have a tendency to having P. versicolor. It can be recurrent. So one of the things that people who have recurrent P. versicolor need to do is boost their immune system, and number two, make an antifungal wash a regular part of their skincare routine. There are antifungal washes available and you can buy over the counter in Nigeria and just use that to wash at least once a week. That will kill the fungal overgrowth on your skin and reduce and treat the P. versicolor. But for people who have a tendency to keep having P. versicolor, it can still, you know, reoccur after a few months. So that's why even when you don't have P. versicolor, you may need to continue to use that wash, antifungal wash, frequently, like once a week or once a month, to prevent its reoccurrence. I hope we've learned about pityriasis versicolor, that it's not actually eczema. But if it's too difficult to pronounce pityriasis versicolor, you can say P. versicolor. All right, take care. Let me know if you have any questions or comments about P. versicolor. We'll talk about the real eczema on another day. Take care. Stay safe. See you later.